Can you hit the plug? I need more. YouTube, what it do, man? It's your boy Kenny, and I'm back for another video, man, right now. I thought to myself, I said, man, you know what, bruh? The audio in the last video was... Maybe the audio in this video gonna be better before I break down and go cop a Yeti mic or whatever. But I also thought, you know what? We haven't live traded. We haven't had a live analysis. We haven't had, like, a live trade where I'm doing a commentary or whatever, doing a voiceover while we're in the trade. So you know what, I woke up a little earlier today. I got to the computer a little earlier today. It's 7:40 right now, Friday, so hopefully we see something going on. Let's check the news. And before we go over the news for the day, if you haven't already, make sure you like this video, spam them soap bars in the comment section, and subscribe to my channel. Turn the post notifications on so you'll be alerted every time I upload a new video. I upload videos every Wednesday and Friday. Yesterday, y'all know we had a bank holiday. I think yesterday was like Veterans Day or something like that. Was it Veterans Day? Yeah, Veterans Day. Whatever, cool. So it was a lot of low volume and things like that. It wasn't nothing going on. You check the charts, we was sitting under this 200 and this 50. We wasn't really making no much noise. I caught this little move up here, took some profits or whatever. So for the news today, we got two little orange folders or three. Ooh, I don't know, man. Today might be a little, we might have some volume because we didn't have nothing going on yesterday. So what I'm expecting price to do today, if we go over here and try and break this down. So previously we had, in the last video, price broke out of this little pattern, whatever, and it just started melting, just melting, 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 melting. We was breaking through all the floors, respecting all the ceilings. As you can see, we continue structure so many times, here, 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 and most, a lot of people thought we was gonna keep going down here. I had a few people send me some posts of them. I guess they had gotten like right around here, and it was like, bro, it's just gonna keep going down, it's gonna keep going down. And that next hour candle came in and said, and swiped them all up. So I know they was hurting, but we're waiting until 8:30 to see what's going on. So let's go ahead and break this down, see what I'm looking at. So like I said, we were continuing structure. Then we came up here to this bank level 16,000. And to me, it looks like we kind of created some type of demand and it came back, picked a little bit of it and retested it, right? So after this retest, we all know, okay, we set this high, we came down, retested this, we should have a massive explosion pushed up to the upside. We have this 50 MA and this 200 MA coming down. So that could either mean this is going to be a good resistance for us to kind of push down, break out of this pattern, grab the orders out of this demand, maybe grab the liquidity from down here. So I'm going to go ahead and put my little dollar sign to represent liquidity. So we all know, when the banks push down and they leave these wigs and things like that, they're either grabbing liquidity from the left side or they're putting in liquidity right here for buy orders. You know, they could have sellers down here. They're still in profit because they got in way up here. So they put in a buy order to make some more money. You know, order flow, institutional order flow. Yeah, I'm about to go over that in another video. It's a few videos I need to do. So yeah, nothing going on right now. What do I believe is to happen? I drew up this little triangle. I'm like, okay, price came in here, made a high. It respected this little trend line and made a low. It made a lower high. It came down here, made a higher low. So now we know, okay, we don't want to break this floor. So now we got to come up to retest this point or this point in structure. We failed to do that about two times right here in this little area right here. So what is that telling me? That's telling me, okay, we got some good resistance here with this 50 and this little resistance box. We also got good resistance with this 200 MA as well. This is like right here on the wicks. So I'm expecting price to either push up, grab the liquidity, and keep going, or expecting price to fake out at here, tap this resistance, come back in here, and drop. Or I'm expecting price to just drop. Let's check the 4 hour, see what's going on the 4 hour. So yeah, we do got, so it looks like with this wick, we kind of like grabbed the liquidity from down in here. We didn't necessarily base ourselves on this little support where most of these orders are. This is probably like an accumulation here and here, but here more importantly, because you have more healthier candles going both ways with the wicks as well. basing itself on this little support line. So I would draw this little support right here. I'm actually going to go ahead and draw that right here, but I'm not too keen on it coming way down here today, at least not in the session that I'm trying to trade in or the hour, because y'all know I'm not trying to stay on here all day. Like I was saying, it looked like we grabbed a liquidity from here, not necessarily here, which where it should have went, but we kind of based ourselves on the 16K bank level, and now we're just kind of bouncing around in here, kind of making like this bullish kind of channel, kind of pull back before we kind of tank down and maybe come down here and grab these orders, fill this wick in, grab the orders from right here, maybe grab this because we've been bearish all week. So yeah, that's what we're looking at right now. We got the 50 kind of in the same spot as it was on the 1 hour. Now on the daily, we got two blue candles from yesterday and today. I don't know. We could see a liquidity grab and push down, or we could just see us chilling in this little channel until next week. We're just gonna have to wait and see what they want to do at 8:30. So if this is what they're gonna give us, this is what they're gonna give us. So yeah, I'm expecting the price to come up here, pop down. Now I was gonna place my fib, but I seen all this jumbleness, and I'm like, okay, fibs are supposed to play out. They're not supposed to jumble around and consolidate and do all this extra stuff, right? So if the fib play was supposed to work out, we were supposed to bounce right off the top of this support and then shoot up. But we've got these two MAs kind of resisting our movement to the top side. So what that's telling me is giving me more of a hint that's like, okay, we got all these higher, lower highs, failed to make a new high, all this, and then we also got all these higher lows, higher lows, higher lows, higher lows. We could do either way. Usually, when the way we come in to a channel or a pattern is the way we leave out of that pattern. So if we come into the pattern down, we're probably gonna come up and down out of the pattern. If that makes any sense, because we've been bearish, right? We've been bearish all week, and then we finally come down after this big move. We have to correct the move, correct? So this is a correction as well. This leg of structure is a correction. So after the correction, we're having a bullish pullback and a bearish trend, right? So ideally, what we want to see is price come up here, maybe tap this 50 and then fake us out and then push down, break this demand level, create some level of supply, grab the liquidity from here, and then find somewhere where it can chill out at. Somewhere right here, somewhere in the midst of this area right here. That's what I want to see ideally. When it gets closer to time for New York Stock Exchange open, I'm gonna come back and then we're gonna take a trade. If we don't take a trade, we don't take a trade. If not, I'm not gonna force nothing. It is Friday, so yeah, we're gonna see what happens. So we back, it's about 8 o'clock right now, and I came down to the 15-minute chart. I was analyzing it, looking at this, and I'm like, all right, cool. I'm seeing this 50 MA kind of carrying us, right? Y'all know the moving averages are like dynamic support and resistance, and by that I mean they're lagging indicators. So you shouldn't use them to want to get in or whatever, but you should want to use them to determine like, okay, what's happened in the past that's going to shape us for the future, right? So we know that these are dynamic support and resistance, meaning as the chart's moving, these are going to move as well. This is acting as support. This is acting as resistance. I call this a little shoulder. This is the little head. And this is the other shoulder. And here's the neckline right there, right? So I'm expecting price to come out and fake us out, grab the liquidity from all these wicks, tap into here, and then come right back down. So right now, this is what we're doing. Look good right now. It's looking a little good right now. We're up about 6.6 pips, a little 20 pip trade. So as this plays out, I think we might look for another setup at about 8:30, see what's going on.
A few moments later.
Now, normally, y'all know I don't be hopping in trades before 8:30. Now, that's a part of my rules. I don't hop in trades before 8:30, but I'm like, okay, this is a nice and neat little setup, though. You know what I'm saying? This is a nice little liquidity grab setup, fake out little setup that I'm trying to take before 8:30. You know what I'm saying? Grab a little bit of pip, you know what I'm saying? Grab a little bit. I don't hop in if the stop loss is too big. I can't get a one-to-one. I'm not gonna hop in if it's crazy news. Y'all know if I need to make a trading plan or a rules video, I'll probably go ahead and do that. But we're gonna wait for this to play out a little bit. I just want a little bit of pip. You know what I'm saying? I don't want too much. I just want a little bit. Right now, we up about 14, 15 pips. I might go ahead and secure the bag real quick. Might go ahead and secure the little baggy bag. If I find another setup, I'll let y'all know. I'll be back. Just like that, we hit targets. You know what I'm saying? So let me go ahead and re-break this trade down for y'all. So like I said, it came in here after all this bearish trend, right? Came in, created this low point. But we've started pushing back bull. So this is considered a correction of this trend continuation, right? A pullback, essentially, a complex pullback. So we created this level of demand on the bank level. We all know that bank levels hold levels of supply and levels of demand, right? That's what's going to push us from top to bottom, from bottom to top. We have this creation of the level of demand. We have a nice retest, tap into this level of demand, and nice push, confirming this level of demand at the bank level. Good two confluences with the retest, another confluence, right? We have a level of support being created because we're not breaking these floors, we're not breaking structure, nor are we breaking to the top side. So we're not breaking any of the highs or any of the lower highs that we're creating, nor are we creating lows, creating lower lows. We're respecting these lows. So essentially, these trend lines indicate that we're not breaking any of the structure. We're not continuing structure. So we came in here, created this low from the high, created a lower high. So if we want to be bearish, like I say in every video, we got to create lower highs and lower lows, right? Uptrends, the opposite. Higher highs, higher lows. Since we're not creating higher highs and higher lows, we're not creating lower lows and lower highs. We're just kind of ranging, consolidating, building up orders at this level underneath these two MAs. So what's telling me is, okay, there's resistance up here from these MAs. There's also support down here that's helping us respect these lower lows, these higher lows that are being formed, right? So hop down to the 15-minute. And I could see, okay, cool. All these orders in here, okay, we ranging because all day, nothing going on too much. All right, right? We have a left shoulder, we have a head, we have a right shoulder. So now we have an inverse head and shoulder with the neckline, buy at the neckline, no drawdown, and we have a straight push up. Grab the liquidity from the top side. And now I'm expecting price to come down at this resistance and come back into this. And now once we get back into this 50 MA, we break it, I might send the trade out to the community for them to take the sell. If you enjoyed my theories and my ideas, and you enjoy listening to me talk and trade this live with y'all, man, go ahead and spam the comment section with the sold bars. Go to my Instagram, spam my page with the sold bars. Leave a like on this video if y'all enjoyed it. And make sure you subscribe to my channel. Turn the post notifications on so every Wednesday and Friday you'll be alerted when the videos drop, when they get published, and you can stay up to date with me. I have all my tags and all my links in the description. If you didn't know, Niggas Gotta Smoke Some More, the EP is finally out in all stores. It just dropped about 8 hours ago at midnight. So y'all go eat that up. I'm gonna put a little snippet at the end of this video, at the end of this clip. And I ain't got too much to say, man. Happy Friday. Have a great weekend. King Soul out this motherfucker.
A few moments later.
What'd I say? What did I say? I literally said price gonna go up, grab the liquidity. We didn't got that trade. And now look at price. Rejected that little area. Killed our dang little support zone. And guess where we're headed to? This little demand. We finna take the liquidity. We probably gonna keep pushing that. Join the community, man. That's all I'm gonna say, y'all. Join the community. Y'all see what I'm doing. Y'all see what? Y'all see the results, man. I ain't came to y'all yet with nothing bad, bro. You know what I'm saying? But hey, I'm not gonna force you to join. I'm not gonna do nothing. I'm gonna just plug myself in. You join. You join. You see the value. You see the value. Simple as that. I mean, look at the candle. Look at the candle. Tell me that's not your bills right there, bro. Tell me that's not your car note right there, bro. Tell me that's not your rent. Tell me that's not your mortgage right there, bro. Tell me that's not your little kid's groceries right there, bro. Come on, bro. King Soap, bro. All love. But I'm out. For real. Look at that candle. This shit too pretty. And Shorty said she love me. Oh yeah, she got a shot.